So once again, welcome back. In the last lecture, we discussed in detail about the concept of PMMC type instrument, that is a permanent magnet moving coil. And finally, we came to know that PMMC type instruments are used for the measurement of DC quantity only. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the remaining two type of analog instrument which works on the principle of magnetic effect, that is EMMC type and MI type analog instrument. So as I told you that if you open any electrical instrument, the main ruling quantity is current and the final output is deflection theta. And in order to convert this input electrical quantity into output mechanical quantity, the analog instrument may used the phenomena of magnetic effect, or you can say induction effect or electrostatic effect. But the thing is that based on the effect which is available in that analog instrument, we are in a position to classify them like magnetic effect based analog instrument or induction effect based analog instrument or electrostatic based analog instrument. Now suppose if we are having an analog instrument which used magnetic effect to convert this input electrical quantity into output mechanical quantity, then they are called as magnetic effect based analog instrument. So I can say that for the working of these type of analog instrument, we required magnetic field as a main working flux or as a main working field. Now in practical domain, it is possible to generate the required amount of magnetic field with the help of two mechanism, either by using permanent magnet or by using electromagnet. In some analog instrument, the required amount of working field, or you can say working flux, is produced with the help of permanent magnet. And in some analog instrument, the required magnetic field, or you can say working field, is produced with the help of, say, electromagnet. So example for this domain is PMMC type instrument, which we learned in the last lecture. So if you open any PMMC type analog instrument, it may be say voltmeter or it may be say ammeter, you will found a permanent magnet available in it, whose main function is to produce the required amount of working flux. Whereas the example for electromagnet domain are EMMC type analog instrument and moving iron type analog instrument. That means if you open any electromagnet moving coil type analog instrument, or you can say moving iron type analog instrument, the required amount of working flux is produced with the help of electromagnet. So let us discuss in detail the working phenomena of EMMC and MI type analog instrument. So if you see the working of EMMC type analog instrument, so it will have two different coil. Let us consider the schematic, or you can say basic diagram of EMMC type instrument. So here we are having two different coil, out of which one coil is fixed and second one is movable. Now to this coil, we need to provide some winding. So this indicate the winding for fixed coil, and then the same winding is continue for moving coil. If you see here, we are having two different coil. This is your fixed coil and this is your moving coil, and to this combination we are going to provide some excitation as an input. So let us consider that here I have connected an alternating voltage source as an input. So because the path is closed and potential difference is available, there will be a flow of current through this winding like this. Now if you apply thumb rule over here, this fixed coil is going to produce its own magnetic field in this direction. So this point will act as a north pole and this point will act as a south pole. So the direction of magnetic fields are like this. In the same way, the same current is flowing through the moving coil, and this coil is again going to produce its own magnetic field. Again, if you apply thumb rule over here, so thumb indicates the direction of magnetic field produced by a moving coil. So it will be like this. So this point is act as a north pole and this point will act as a south pole. In the same way, the direction of field produced by this moving coil is like this. Now if you connect a pointer to this moving coil, and if you provide some calibrated scale over here, now see here, in this arrangement we are having two different magnet. Both the magnets are you can say electromagnet, out of which one magnet is fixed, and that's why it is called as fixed coil, and another is movable. That means depending upon the force of attraction, or you can say force of repulsion between these two arrangement, this coil will make some movement. Now in this case, depending upon the polarity of this input voltage applied as an input to this particular arrangement, here we are having south pole and here we are having north pole, so there will be a force of attraction between these two coil, because this coil is fixed and this coil is moving. So because of that force of attraction, this moving coil will try to move towards the fixed coil, and as the pointer is connected to the moving coil, so depending upon the force of attraction which is developed between these two arrangement, this pointer will change from its initial position and indicating theta as an output. So this is what the basic working principle of EMMC type electromagnet. Why it is called as EMMC type analog instrument? Because here we are having two coil. First one is your moving coil, which act as an electromagnet, which is going to produce the required amount of working flux, whereas we are having another coil which is movable in nature. That's why a combination of electromagnet moving coil. And EMMC type analog instrument works on the principle of mutual inductance, which is very very important. So whatever the mutual inductance between these two electromagnet, based on that mutual inductance value, it is going to generate the output force which is responsible to create theta as a deflection. And the second thing is that EMMC type instruments are used for the measurement of AC power. To be frank, EMMC type instruments are used for the measurement of both AC quantities as well as for DC quantity. That means instead of applying AC, if you apply DC, in that case also EMMC type instruments are going to work. But the thing is that when the EMMC instruments are used for the measurement of AC power, their efficiency is at its best value. That is the reason EMMC instruments are used for the measurement of AC power only. Now, from this diagram it is very clear that EMMC type instruments require two different coil for its working. First one is your fixed coil and second one is your moving coil, and we know that for each coil we are having two terminal. So if you consider this is your first coil, which is nothing but a fixed coil, so for fixed coil we are having two terminal. Suppose this is 1 and 1 dash. In the same way, we are having another coil which is movable in nature, which is called as moving coil, and let us consider the terminals of moving coil are 2 and 2 dash. So if you see closely, as because we are having two different coil for the working of electromagnet moving coil type analog instrument, and for each coil we are having two terminal, so total number of terminals as an output we saw for electromagnet moving coil type analog instruments are 4. So here we are having 4 terminal as an output, out of which two terminals are for fixed coil and two terminals are for moving coil, which is very very important. So कहने का मतलब ये है कि जब भी आप electromagnet moving coil type analog instrument के साथ काम करेंगे तो आपके पास में output में चार terminal रहेंगे, जो कि हमने PMMC के केस में हमने सिर्फ दो ही टर्मिनल देखा था एज एन आउटपुट. क्यों PMMC के केस में दो टर्मिनल थे? क्योंकि PMMC के केस में हमारे पास में सिर्फ एक ही कॉइल था, दैट इज योर मूविंग कॉइल, एंड द रिक्वायर्ड अमाउंट ऑफ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज प्रोड्यूस विद द हेल्प ऑफ परमानेंट मैग्नेट. सो इन PMMC वी आर हैविंग ओनली वन कॉइल, दैट्स वाई वी आर हैविंग ओनली टू टर्मिनल एज एन आउटपुट. वेयर एज इन केस ऑफ EMMC टाइप एनालॉग इंस्ट्रूमेंट, बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग टू कॉइल एज its working component, that's why we are having four terminal as an output. Now let us try to analyze the working of moving iron type instrument, moving iron, or in short it is nothing but MI type instrument. So as I told you that in moving iron type instrument, the required amount of magnetic field is produced with the help of what? Electromagnet. So definitely here we are having one electromagnet which is fixed in nature, and here I am showing the coils for that electromagnet, and to this electromagnet we are providing some input voltage as an excitation. So here I have connected a AC voltage source as an input quantity. Because the potential difference is available and the path is closed, there will be a flow of current through this coil, and depending upon the magnitude of current flowing through this coil, it will produce its own magnetic field as an output. So if you apply thumb rule over here, so thumb indicate the direction of magnetic field produced by this coil, which is nothing but a fixed coil. So here this point is north pole and this point is south pole. So the direction of magnetic field is like this. Now to this arrangement we are going to place a soft iron disc. Soft iron disc. Now when we placed a soft iron disc in the vicinity of this magnetic field, because we know that it is an iron disc and this is nothing but your magnet, no doubt it is an electromagnet, but ultimately it is nothing but a magnet, so there will be a force of attraction between this magnet and this soft iron disc, and because of the force of attraction between this magnet and this soft iron disc, the pointer will indicate output theta. So suppose if you connect a pointer to this soft iron disc, and if you provide a calibrated scale over here, then depending upon the force of attraction between this magnet and this soft iron disc, the pointer will move from its initial position and indicate theta as an output. So this is the basic working of moving iron type analog instrument, and it works on the principle of self inductance. Second thing is that instead of supplying AC power as an input, if you connect a DC, in that case also the moving iron type analog instruments are capable to create deflection as an output. But the thing is that moving iron type instruments are used only for the measurement of AC voltage and current. Why? Because if you provide or if you measure the magnitude of AC voltage, or you can say AC current, with the help of MI as compared to EMMC type instrument, their efficiencies are good. That is the reason in most of the cases, if you are interested to measure AC voltage or you can say AC current, moving iron type instruments are used. So till now we discussed in detail about the basic of PMMC type instrument, then moving iron type instrument, and then EMMC type instrument. So if you make a comparative analysis of these three instruments based on various operating parameter, so here I am writing the operating parameter based on which we are going to make a comparison between PMMC type instrument, MI type instrument and EMMC type instrument. So the first operating parameter is working principle. So PMMC type instrument works on the principle of Lorentz force equation, whereas moving iron type instruments works on the principle of self-inductance, and EMMC type instrument works on the principle of mutual inductance. Second thing, depending upon the way we produced the required amount of magnetic field for its working purpose. So depending upon how we produced magnetic field in that instrument, we can make a comparative analysis between PMMC, MI and EMMC type instrument. So in case of PMMC type instrument, the required amount of magnetic field is produced with the help of permanent magnet, whereas in case of moving iron type instrument, the required amount of magnetic field is produced with the help of electromagnet, and in this case also it is electromagnet. Then third parameter on which we will make a comparative analysis is depending upon the number of coils available in it. So in case of PMMC type instrument, we are having only one coil, and that coil is moving coil, whereas in case of MI type instrument, again we are having only one coil, but it is a fixed coil. But in case of electromagnet moving coil type analog instruments, we are having two coil. First one is your moving coil and second one is your fixed coil. Then fourth parameter is depending upon the number of terminals which are available as an output. That means when you are using PMMC type instrument for the measurement of any unknown quantity, how many terminals are available as an output for PMMC type instrument and for MI type instrument and for EMMC type instrument. So in case of PMMC type instrument, as we are having only one coil, that's why two terminal per coil. So here we are having two terminal as an output. In MI again we are having only one coil, but that too fixed. Again here we are having two terminal as an output. And in case of EMMC type instrument, because we are having two coil and two terminals per coil, that's why we are having four terminal as an output. That means जब भी आप EMMC type instrument use करोगे तो आपके पास चार terminal as an output रहेंगे, जबकि MI के case में सिर्फ दो ही terminal रहेंगे और PMMC के case में भी सिर्फ दो ही terminal रहेंगे. Then point number 5 is comparative analysis based on the nature of quantity. Nature of quantity, that means what quantity is used for determining in case of PMMC or in case of MI or in case of EMMC. So PMMC type instruments are used for the measurement of DC voltage, or you can say current. MI type instruments are used for the measurement of AC, that too voltage and current. And EMMC type instruments are used for the measurement of AC, that too power only. That means PMMC instrument का use हम कहाँ करेंगे? अगर मान लो मेरे पास में DC circuit voltage है या फिर DC circuit current है, उसको measure करना है, तो we are going to use PMMC instrument. Whereas if I am interested to measure AC, that too voltage and current, I am going to use moving iron type instrument. Whereas for the measurement of AC power, we are going to use EMMC type instrument only. In the next lecture, we will discuss how to generate the controlling torque and damping torque for the operation of any analog instrument. Thank you.